The Uganda Security and Printing Company was incorporated in 2018 to print security documents such as passports, driving permits, and national identity cards, with another long-term plan to be able to produce money. But to date, the company has not kicked off. This is due to delayed construction works on the building that will host the factory.
That certain people would seek to deliberately prolong production of the e-passports locally, so that we remain here, you know, buying from out when actually the beneficiaries are even here. To put our feet on the ground and push this matter to a logical conclusion. To want as a committee, and what is actually defendable is to have these passports being produced here in the medium term.
So what was the agreement saying that they will complete in how many years?
The estimate at that time was within 2 years they should have started construction, should have been complete. Unfortunately, force majeure, a number of things happened. The COVID came in, that also affected production. They were expecting also to get finances both from the purchase of passports, the purchase of identity cards, and the purchase from the driving permits, but all these were curtailed by subsequent events, more especially the COVID that affected them. So, but negotiations have gone on and they have gotten the money. I believe they have enough monies now at least to continue with the construction. That should be on course now. We should look forward to the next 2 years to have this in place.
MPs on the Defense Committee are concerned that this is the reason Ugandans continue to pay high fees for passports.
Expecting this, because by the look of things, you can see that there is a lot of overcharging when you look at the cost per. The price is too high. When are we starting to produce our own booklets here?
VA provided for only 260,000 passports per year. But now we find that we actually need more than 500. We actually estimate come up to a level of about 600 passports in a year. And yet in the budget provision was only for 240. So this was the request now for the extra 260 in order to be able to be compliant with applicants' requirements.
To acquire the new e-passport, applicants have to apply online and pay 250,000 shillings for ordinary and 500,000 shillings for express processing. The subject on passports was raised after the Ministry of Internal Affairs officials, led by the Director of Citizenship and Immigration Control, Major General Apollo Kasita Goa, were presenting their supplementary expenditure for the financial year 2022-2023. Officials couldn't commit themselves to timelines on when the Uganda Security and Printing Company would start work, citing COVID-19 as the cause of the delays.
Perception sometimes, which is wrong, that the project is entirely dependent on the internal affairs, which it is not. This is supposed to, ideally it was conceived to domesticate the production of all security documents. That was the mindset of especially the president, to stop the hemorrhage of giving money to outsiders. And part of it was constructing that factory. That factory is supposed to produce passports, supposed to produce other documents. And
there's no ban on construction. The president was very categorical. And other offices, government offices, were still running. We have seen so many PPP ventures ending up hitting a snag. We are now looking at 43, not actually 42 euros. Euros, it is too expensive. And you know, when you came up with this venture, you were telling Ugandans that now the cost of the passport was going to be more cheaper. So I just want the director to help us as a committee. What do you really think did not go on during that time of COVID that it really stopped the progress of the project?
The chairperson of the defense committee, Rosemary Nyachikongoro, resolved to have a field visit to the stalled factory site in Entebbe.
Already picked interest. Actually, we shall be visiting that place this week. And we also intend to do some more investigations.
Uganda Security Printing Company was formulated in November 2018 as a special purpose vehicle to revamp Uganda Printing and Publishing Corporation. The company was formulated as a joint venture between the government of Uganda and a German consortium, Veridos. The company entered into a 15-year partnership with the government to provide the country with all the relevant security documents. Report by Fred Kajiwi for the news at Parliament.